Hello friends, good morning and good evening everyone. Your ALP here. Welcome to our channel ALP Talks, General and Electrical Aspects. So in today's interview question, so the question is open circuit in a secondary CT. So why CT secondary should not be open circuited? So this is one of the interview question. Many electrical guys will experience this in interviews. So let's discuss why it should not be open circuited and all. So everyone, we all know that the CT, for example, here I just shown a CT like a ring CT, ring type CT. So this is the core and this is the primary winding and this is the secondary winding. So whenever a primary winding generally will be like almost a bar or cable, anything like that. So it will simply passes through the CT core, and the CT secondary is there. Whenever primary carries any current, say for example I1 current, so there will be a flux production in the core, and similarly the flux links with the secondary, and secondary also there will be an induced EMF. Whenever you are connecting any circuit in the secondary like meter or anything, so then there will be a flow of current in the secondary circuit, and the whatever the current flowing, that opposes the clock, that opposes the cause of producing it. So that opposes the flux, electromagnetic flux, whatever generated in the core. So like that is a continuous process. So that keep on acts. For example, I equal V minus UZ. So instantaneously these things will happen in the current transformer. So this is the circuit guys. So this is the, so I just drawn inductor and resistor just to show the inductive part and the resistive part of the system, and this is the primary circuit. So in primary we all know that generally it will draw little bit more current, magnetizing current, that will magnetize the core for producing working flux. So that's what this equation shows, and this is resistive per core loss, and this is the magnetizing this is the shunt branch actually. So generally the magnetizing current or no load current, whatever it is, they generally that will be in normal cases, it will be like 5% whenever there is load on the secondary side, and almost remaining 95% will be utilized for working current. That is the actual case. But what happens whenever a CT is open circuited? This is the question we are going to discuss now. Whenever CT is open circuited, open means that's it, right? Open. So there is no flow of any current in the secondary. So normal cases, MMFs in both sides are equal. N1 I1 equal to N2 I2. Both sides, the primary MMF and second MMF, both are equal. But what happens when CT is open circuited? When CT is open circuited, the current is zero. So secondary MMF, whatever it is there, that becomes zero. But still the primary MMF will be there. That is the main difference from transformer and current transformer. So in this current transformer, the primary MMF will still be there like earlier case. Even the load is not there, but still, because secondary circuit is independent of primary circuit, the primary circuit will carry still 100% MMF like earlier case. The MMF is very high. So what it will do? So even here the load is zero, right? Now it is zero. So everything will flow into this. I already written 100% here. So everything will flow, will be like a magnetizing current. So here you can see characteristic curve. This is voltage and this is the current. So whenever in normal cases, what happens is we will operate the CT at below knee point voltage. So this is the magnetizing current IM. This will be like 5%. So the intended operation will be done if this is below the knee point voltage. So what happening now, because CT is open circuited, so it will draw whatever the current is there in primary circuit, everything will be like a magnetizing current. So we are pushing the core into the saturation region, so the core will be saturated. That is one thing, and there will be very huge amount of flux. The MMF is very high, there will be huge flux in the core. So whenever there is a huge flux, means there will be huge voltage in the secondary. Very high voltages will be induced in the secondary, and all the secondaries are insulated with respect to the inductor and with respect to the core by using some cotton tape or some resin or with any pressboard material. That is the general consideration. But that insulation may fail because there is huge, very high voltage, right? The insulation get puncture, and there can be shock or death to the people also if the voltage is very high. Means the persons who are the operating there, or maintenance people are there, it is very risky for them. for their life also. And generally there is a voltage into current, right, VA, that is the entire VA will dissipated as a heat in the core itself, because there is no secondary to utilize that load current and the power, even though it is small power, but everything will be dissipating in the core itself. So if it is oil type CT, what happens, the oil gets heated due to the heat content in the core. So oil may get boiled in the less span of time, and arc energy also will be very high. And what happens, there will be more pressure inside the oil tank, and there may be chances for CT blast also, that also may happen. Yeah, so that is one thing. And say for example, this is the sinusoidal voltage, we all know the sinusoidal voltage. So as CT is already saturated due to this very high level of magnetizing current, it got saturated. So this is no more CT, is no more CT now. It is like a dummy, it is like the simply core, simply like coil. So what happens is, it will just from 0 to, say this is the maximum, this is the maximum in negative direction. So 0 to up to a few portion of the cycle only, it may act like an induction. Remaining portion, it will simply nothing, no EMF will be induced, but still very high voltage will be there due to this higher flux current, higher flux. And how to avoid these problems? So we can generally all the CT terminals will bring to the any one box in the around the transformer or control panel or anywhere. There will be small control box will be there, some terminal blocks will be there. So on the terminal blocks we will bring two leads, for example S1 and S2, say two leads. So these two leads we will bring here. So there will be some shorting link, so some copper or copper shorting link will be there. So sometimes people also will use some small cable, some small bus bar also people will use. You can simply put the those terminals along these terminal blocks. This is the test terminal block. So what happens is, we just shorted these two terminals, so we are now safe. So what safe with the sense, when we are not using this CT, then what happens is, as we just shorted it, there will be flow of current in the secondary circuit, then there will be flow, so this is get balanced, the MMF in both sides are getting balanced, that's what we should do. So these things are very important, guys. For example, whenever any person, there is any inauguration or starting of any new plant, power plant or anything, we will call for any guest, right? So whenever guest is coming and whenever he is pressing the inauguration or green button or anything starting the plant, so suddenly wherever CTs are there, if they were not short circuited, then what happens, there will blast will happen. So these things happen many times in India and abroad also, in many power plants and many other small industry inaugurations or installations. So these things you have to take care, guys. But these high voltage or these things won't happen in transformer. Why? Because in transformer the primary is not like a fixed one, it will just adjust based on the load requirement. But in current transformer the primary is very primary is fixed irrespective of secondary load. Yeah, this is about this, guys. So we just discussed why CT should not be open circuited in secondary, and what happens if CT is open circuited. Yeah, this is about this, guys. I hope you enjoyed the content. If you have any questions or comments or anything, then do comment in comment section. And if you enjoyed the content, do like it and subscribe to this channel for many more updates. Yeah, we'll meet in next video. Bye.